Greetings of the day, dear students. I am Ms. Sarika Joshi, Assistant Professor at AISSMS College of Hotel Management and Catering Technology. Brings you another session on pest control. Keeping down pests or pest control is important because pests can cause diseases and discomfort. Pests are usually such organisms in nature that they can grow everywhere and they may attack the cleanest of the establishment. The objectives of today's session are to define pests, to identify different types of pests, to explain the characteristics of these pests, and how to ensure a better pest control. Let us first see what are pests. A pest is an organism that competes with humans, domestic animals, or desirable plants for food and water. A pest may injure humans, domestic animals, desirable plants, structures, or possessions. They can transmit diseases to humans, domestic animals, wildlife, or desirable plants, and annoys humans or domestic animals. Now, where do these pests get an opportunity to come into an organization? That means, how do they enter the organization? The pests can invade hotels, resort in a wide variety of ways. Hotels have a constant traffic from guests, employees, and deliveries, which leave them vulnerable to pest introduction. Especially in the delivery areas, flies, mice, rats can be a problem if exterior dumpsters are in the same area. Guests and employees can unknowingly introduce pests to your property on their personal belongings too. So, definitely it becomes a responsibility of housekeeping and maintenance department to keep a close track of the same. Frequent and regular inspections by housekeeping staff can help to identify these issues or problems. You should empower them by providing training on common pests and sign of their presence. It is also important to establish a strong relationship with the pest control provider who can inspect the area thoroughly and can help control pests. Let us see the types of pests. The types of pests can be divided into the first category, which is insects such as cockroaches, termites, beetles, and fleas. Arthropods, which is nothing but 8-legged insects such as mites, ticks, and spiders, which fall into this category. Pests can also be like microbial organisms such as bacteria. They may be vertebrates such as mice or other rodents. This is a general categorization of different category of pests. In the upcoming slides, now we shall see what are the pest control goals. So the first pest control goal is prevention. Prevention is keeping a pest away from becoming a problem. This may be a goal when the pest's presence or abundance can be predicted in advance. Continuous pests, by definition, are usually very predictable. If you know there are circumstances and conditions which are favoring their presence, then you may prevent such kind of situations. The next goal of pest control is suppression. Reducing the pest numbers or damage to an acceptable level is called as suppression of pests. This is a common goal for any pest situation. The intent is to reduce the number of pests to a level where the harm they cause is just about acceptable. Once a pest presence is detected and control is deemed necessary, suppression and prevention are often joint goals. The third and the major goal is eradication, that is destroying an entire pest population. This is a rare goal for outdoor pest situations in particular because it is difficult to achieve. Usually the goal is prevention or suppression, and eradication is occasionally attempted when a foreign pest has been accidentally introduced into your environment. After looking at the common goals of pest control now, we shall see some common pests which are found in an organization. The first one that we are going to look here is a bed bugs. Yes, if you look at the structure or the image of the bed bug in the adjoining image, they are typically yellow to white in color and can leave a small blood stain on sheets or walls. They also give off a very unpleasant odor, and that's how you can make out that there are bed bugs in the surrounding. They lay eggs in crevices and stuck to these surfaces. They are tiny parasitic creatures that feed on blood of humans and animals. They can cause severe irritation on whomever they are feeding on, and which ultimately leads to loss of sleep and lack of energy, especially in children. Bed bugs can hide in crevices of beds, furniture, upholstery, wallpaper, skirting, boards, etc. The common eradication of bed bugs can be done by treating the premises thoroughly by fumigation. Also, by pouring boiling water into crevices is a temporary solution. Bed bugs can be eradicated by applying a thick layer of kerosene oil or emulsion, which can be an effective way of eradication for bed bugs. The next common type of a pest that we can see is carpet beetle. Carpet beetle usually attracts fur, carpets, and all types of woolen textile. An adult carpet beetle is about 2 to 4 mm long with a highly convex body, and its color is variable from brown or black and is mottled with yellow or white scales on its back. Carpet beetles are pests of animal and occasionally plant products. They have emerged as a major pest to hotel textiles, thriving in the uniform temperature that result from the central heating. Carpet beetles flourish in situations where they can remain undisturbed, for example, beneath the carpets, around the skirting boards, and in the wardrobes. After looking at a common characteristics of carpet beetle and where they can be found, let us see how they can be eradicated. Frequent and thorough vacuum cleaning of fluff and dust is essential to get rid of carpet beetles. In case of infestation, that is, if they are found in large population, insecticide powders may be spread in affected areas. Now let's have a look at the next common type of a pest, which we call it as a fabric moth. As the name says, the natural haunts of these insects are carpets, clothing, and general debris. Most cloth or fabric moths belong to the family of Tinidae. The adult moths are generally small insects with a wingspan of 10 to 20 mm, more or less brownish in color, but often with a golden or a silvery sheen, as you can see in the adjoining image. Damage is visible by irregular surfaces or holes on the fabric. That's when you can make out that probably there is an attack of the fabric moth. Cloth moths or fabric moths are most likely to attack the fabrics which are soiled by perspiration, urine, or stained by food and beverage. And that's the reason why cleaning or hygiene is utmost important. They can attack only natural fabrics, which I mean to say either cotton or wool. Synthetic fibers are relatively safe, and fabric moths generally do not attack synthetic fibers. As I already mentioned, the adult moths are generally with a wingspan of 10 to 20 and are brownish and silvery in color. To get rid of fabric moth, they can be minimized if man-made fabric is used in the organization wherever possible. In case of moth infestation, that is, if the population is too high, fabrics can be also treated with a moth-proof finish. A dry atmosphere and a use of insecticide may also help to control the spread of fabric moth. All infested items should be thrown out. Either they should be laundered or they should be dry cleaned. That means utmost cleaning of the fabric is an essential step to eradicate the fabric moth. Also, vacuum cleaning of the infested areas, especially under the edges of carpets, under the furniture and wardrobe, also cupboards, can help you to get rid of the fabric moths. Going ahead, we shall look at the very common kind of a pest, mosquitoes. As we all know, they transmit diseases such as malaria, filaria, and yellow fever. The most effective way of stopping growth of mosquitoes is by stopping the breeding, their breeding, which can be attained by not allowing water to stagnate. That means if there is any water which is allowed to stagnate in your surrounding areas, you should very surely get rid of that. You should throw that water and keep the areas dry and clean. This will help them from coming and settling down onto that particular water, and thus will stop their breeding. Not only this, but drains should also be covered. One kerosene oil should be poured into it or over it to prevent the growth of larvae, which are the eggs laid by the mosquitoes. Fine gauze on windows prevents their entry. But typically in an hotel organization, to stop their entry, as you know, it is a centralized air conditioning which has been provided in the organization, automatically their entry is restricted. Moving ahead, fungi. It is a form of wet and dry rot which can cause considerable damage to the property. As you can see in the adjoining images, fungus or fungi is further divided into wet rot or a dry rot. And the kind of structure that it has attacked typically is a wooden structure. Let us first have a look at a wet rot. It is found in kitchens, bathrooms, and roofs. As the name suggests, it says wet, that means wherever there is lot of humidity or moisture, there is major chances of attack by a wet rot. So it attacks window frames, sills, and doors which are made up from wooden or wood. The affected surface becomes dark brown to black, and it also becomes spongy as it absorbs moisture. To prevent the wet rot, it is best to call the pest control firms. Timber can be treated with water repellent preservatives. As you know, timber is a wood which has been used to make the window frames or doors. It can be treated with water repellent preservatives so that it is not attacked by a wet rot. Coming to dry rot, it is caused by a fungus that thrives in a damp, still and warm conditions. As here I am stressing on the warm conditions, and that's the reason we call it as a dry rot. They liberate microscopic spores like a red dust, as you can see in the first image. Areas which are most likely to be affected are under floorboards and behind the skirtings. The eradication of dry rot must be handled by experts. So these two are again very commonly found in organizations where there is a use of wooden structure or wood which has been used in the furniture. Silverfish, a very common one, commonly found all over. As the name suggests, these insects are silvery gray in color and they look like a minute fish without fins, and that's why the name silverfish. The size of this pest is about very tiny, 1 centimeter, and these are mostly found in moist areas as they feed on cellulosic material such as paper and cotton. If you have ever noticed that if you are cleaning your shelf after a long time, which is full of stationery, etc., you may come across these kind of pests, which we call it as a silverfish. To prevent the growth of silverfish, moist area should be clean. And for killing them, insecticides like pyrethrum and sodium fluoride can be used. Another very commonly found pest is cockroach. Who's not scared and who doesn't want to get rid of them? These are two common species of cockroaches which I have shown in the adjoining image. The first one is a German cockroach and the second is an Oriental cockroach. The common size of cockroaches typically ranges between 20 to 24 mm and Oriental cockroaches are a little bigger in size, which may range up to 30 mm. Oriental cockroach is a dark brown in color and it prefers a cooler, less humid climate environment, while the German cockroach is little yellowish brown in color and it prefers warm, humid environment. So which are the common areas where you typically see these cockroaches? Yes, these are our kitchen areas, near or under the sinks or the pipes where usually they are grown in abundance. As they usually come out in dark, it is difficult to spot them in the daylight. For eradicating cockroaches, proprietary cockroach killers are used and for pest control, experts are called if the problem persists. Going ahead, mice and rats. Mice and rats are rodents. Both are responsible for many diseases like food poisoning, infection, and jaundice. As you know that we are talking here about the hospitality organization where food becomes the most important part. Hence, the usual entry of rats and mice typically at the time of delivery of the material also in stores can be found in a large scale. Mice and rats can contaminate foodstuff, worktop utensils with their urine and fur, and that is very dangerous for our health. The most effective method of controlling them is poisoning. So there are rat poison which is available in the market, or fumigating, which is an essential way. There are some traps also which can be used to catch mice and rats. Control some of the common control measures for pests. Now, as you know, we are talking about the hotel industry to appeal to the guests, restaurant diners or leisure customers, and to ensure that we have a repeat business, the hospitality industry needs to focus on two vital areas, which is pest control and hygiene. Pest control is important for hotels on several levels. Customers expect to have an enjoyable stay in a pleasant environment and can be safe and secure whether they are in a hotel room or a bathroom or any other facility of the hotel. Now, some of the ways hotels can minimize pests are: the first one is to have an integrated pest management policy. The management should have annual maintenance with the pest control companies, which on regular basis do come to the establishment and can help control pests. Not only this, you can monitor your hotel for signs of pest. So for this, as I already mentioned, the housekeeping and the maintenance staff can be given a training on how to identify the common pest, and if the problem is brought to a light on a regular basis, pests can be easily controlled. Prioritize pest prevention. Preventive measures should be taken so that, such as hygiene and sanitation, which helps to take care of the pests. Mostly, as I said, use a professional pest prevention and control services, as these are commonly given on contractual basis and is a work done by experts. Here I have listed some of the companies that provide professional pest control services, and the most common one is Rentokil, Orkin and Get Pest Control, etc. The hotels usually have a annual maintenance with these kind of companies who do regularly visit the premises and helps in controlling the pests. The references for this particular session I have taken from Hotel Housekeeping Operations and Management by G. Raghubalan and Smriti Raghubalan. And the images that I have used for this session are taken from Google Images, which are labeled for reuse. So, dear students, thank you very much for watching this video. I have mentioned a quiz in the description of this particular video, which will help you to solve some of the very common questions which are based on pest control, and to improvise and to check your knowledge based on pest types of pest and their control. A small quote that I have mentioned here by Jean Della Breyer is, the first day one is a guest, the second a burden, and the third is a pest. So it is very important to have a good control on pest. So thank you very much once again for watching this. I shall see you soon in my next session. Till then, take care. Thank you so much.